With us, we have Elos Medtech and the CEO, Jan. And for people unfamiliar with Elos Medtech, can you give us a short introduction?
Absolutely. Elos Medtech is a medtech company, as you can tell from the name. We mainly are a contract manufacturing company and development of products to the big implant companies within orthopedic, dental, and life science. As a combination to that, we also develop own products, have some own IP that we mainly sell to the same type of customers.
I see. And if we look now at the Q3 figures, you delivered a growth of about 2% on top line. Is that satisfying?
Well, the growth of 2% as such is maybe not satisfying. The growth we have for the first nine months are a little bit above 10%. And I think that's more representative for where we have been over the last couple of years. We were at about 10% also the year before. This year has been a little bit special because we had one customer that we, together with them, decided that to move those the products that we made for them to insource them to their own manufacturing. It was outside our medtech area to that customer. And that meant that we had a fantastic sales in Q1 and beginning of Q2 to them, and then less in Q3 because it was more that they took over the entire inventory in the first half. So if you look at the year to date, the a little bit above 10% is a number and a figure that we are happy with.
And then if we look at the result, looks better with the growth of 20%. Can you explain the result a bit?
Absolutely. We are really happy with the result development. We are now five quarters in a row with improved profitability. And now we moved from about 6% on EBIT level to over 9%, close to 10% in EBIT profitability. And that's definitely a trend that we want to continue. We have worked a lot on reducing scrap and operation efficiency in our sites. But we also worked in specialization to make sure that we take on new products and projects that fit into our line of specialty and maybe remove things that are outside our special areas of interest. And as I mentioned, the company that moved products away in the first half was part of that specialization strategy that we have. So we believe that we have developed in a good way and hope to continue in that way.
And do you see any risk that you're going to look at the result and developing the result too much almost and not focusing on growth on top level?
It's always, of course, the discussion on the focus on growth and profitability. We've had a good focus on growth over the last 2-3 years, and we're going to continue to have that focus. At the same time, we need to get the profitability to develop in a good way because, of course, we need the cash flow to grow faster. So I think it is a combination. You need to work on both areas, and I do believe we have a good balance in growth towards profitability, as it has been, and I hope that we will continue to do it in the same way moving forward.
Yeah, if we'll stay at the profitability a bit, you have a little bit left to reach your EBIT margin target of 13%. How will you reach that goal?
We do. We moved a good way from the 6 to 9.5% or so, but we still have quite a distance to go to get to 13%. It is a tough target, especially as a contract manufacturer. I believe we can get there by continue the specialization and focus on the orthopedic and dental and life science areas instead of more areas that we did in the past. I also believe that the development of our own products that we mainly have in the dental area, that they will give us a better profitability margin as we then sell with our own brand and have a chance to actually get better margin in those products.
Okay, I see. Final question then. You mentioned in your Q3 that a little bit about robot surgery and that you're sort of developing something within this area. Can you explain a bit?
Absolutely. We have one of our sites, the one in US, is 100% focused on orthopedic products, and we make drills, pins and wires, anything that cuts or pierces bone. This is an area that is really important for robotic surgery. They need a lot of those products in that area. And robotic surgery is one of the fastest growing areas within orthopedics, or maybe within medical technology. It's you see a lot of the big companies selling those machines into the hospitals around the world. We believe that we're well positioned with the products that we do for those kind of applications, and we believe that we can continue to grow that business in a good way moving forward. So it's one of the three areas that we see that we can grow our business in a good way. That's also why we actually extended our facility in the US to twice the manufacturing site size to make sure that we can capture that opportunity. Other areas that we believe that can help us in growing the company is, as I mentioned, the own products within dental, the Elos Accurate products. And the third area is within specialized polymers for life science, which is also a reason why we actually now in Q3 decided to expand the facility we have in Skara that work on those kind of products. So that's the next area that we want to expand our site.
I see. Thank you very much for stopping by and answering some questions, and good luck in the future.
Thanks a lot.